Welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, the J&K government has vowed a fast-track trial in the Kathua rape case. And India has offered soybean exports to China amid a trade war with the US. In UK, Prime Minister Theresa May is confident about the success of the airstrikes on Syria. And UK's High Commissioner to India has condemned the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has appealed for peace over the Fagwara clash. And famous Punjabi singer Parmeesh Verma has been shot. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The J&K government has promised a fast-track court to punish the guilty in the Kathua rape case. The BJP accepted the resignation of two ministers from the Jammu and Kashmir coalition government. It said that their unwise move to pacify people rallying for suspects of rape and murder of a minor was mistaken for trying to shield the accused. In the wake of a raging US-China trade war, India has offered to export soybean and other agriculture products to Beijing, which has slapped retaliatory tariffs on American products. India also slammed the US for its protectionist trade policies, saying the unseemly practice has hurt the world's economic recovery. On a day the US and its allies pounded Syria in retaliation for what they call a chemical attack by the Assad regime on civilians, India called for restraint. It has urged that dialogue was the way forward. Over 100 missiles were fired in what US President Donald Trump called precision strikes against Syria. Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu will celebrate his birthday on April 20th by fasting. He has planned a day-long hunger strike at Amravati in a protest against the injustice meted out to the state by the centre. He's been demanding special category status for the newly formed state. The government will seek the Election Commission's opinion on whether simultaneous election to the Lok Sabha and state assemblies be held in multiple phases beginning next year. The amendments are in line with the ones recommended by a parliamentary panel and the Niti Aayog. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has appealed to the Maoist youth to shun their guns and join the mainstream for development in which the government would protect their rights. He also appealed to the people from the backward districts to join a mass movement with a different approach, laced with information technology for the transformation. Former Himachal Pradesh Governor V.S. Kokje has been elected as VHP's new international president, for which voting was held for the first time in over 5 decades. The organization's members had earlier failed to reach a consensus on a new international president. The CBI has booked former UCO Bank CMD Arun Kaul and others for allegedly cheating the bank to the tune of 621 crore rupees. The agency is carrying out searches at 10 locations, 8 of them in Delhi and 2 in Mumbai in this connection. India shone on the penultimate day of the 21st Commonwealth Games. The country claimed its biggest single-day haul of the ongoing edition in snaring 8 gold medals across 5 disciplines. The country held on to the third position in the overall medal tally with 59 medals, 25 gold, 16 silver and 18 bronze medals. Bollywood actor Rajpal Yadav, his wife and a company have been convicted in a recovery suit filed against them. Rajpal Yadav had taken a 5 crore rupees loan in 2010 for his directorial debut Ata Pata Lapata. The film was released in 2012 but Rajpal did not repay his loan. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are: Prime Minister Theresa May is confident about the success of the airstrike on the suspected chemical weapons facilities in Syria. May justified the move by calling it right and legal action. Britain and its allies targeted bases near Damascus following a suspected chemical attack on the Syrian town of Douma. UK's High Commissioner to India, Dominic Asquith, has condemned the Jallianwala Bagh massacre on its 99th anniversary. Asquith also remembered former Prime Minister David Cameron's statement, terming the massacre as a deep shame to British history. A woman who was talking to her friend in Spanish was attacked and told to speak English in a racially aggravated assault. The incident took place on a central line train. The victim was pulled around by her hair, which resulted in injuries to her scalp and cuts on her face. Opposition leader Jeremy Corbyn has condemned the Syria airstrike, claiming that bombs won't save lives. He also said that Prime Minister Theresa May should have sought approval from Parliament before ordering a cruise missile strike against Syria. Demonstrators are set to hit the streets of Edinburgh demanding that the Britons must be given a chance to vote on the final Brexit deal. The organisers claim that the march will be the largest ever pro-European day of action. Migration has caused surge in housing prices as per a report. The data was released following Housing Minister Dominic Raab's claim that immigration had caused house prices to rise by 20% over 25 years. National Security Advisor Sir Mark Sedwill has claimed that Russian intelligence agencies targeted Yulia Skripal's email account as early as in 2013. The claim was made by Sedwill in a letter to NATO. Yulia was attacked with a nerve agent along with her father Sergei, a former Russian spy. The authority running the Lake District National Park has been accused of violating its World Heritage status. Campaigners say a massive increase in motorbikes and 4x4 vehicles has profoundly changed the landscape. England has made history by reaching their first Commonwealth Games netball final. The country beat Jamaica in the semi-finals with a dramatic comeback. England has never reached a global final since 1975 and have never won a major title. Three female jockeys are seeking a place in history as they prepare to line up for the rain-hit Grand National at Aintree. Katie Walsh, Bryony Frost and Rachel Blackmore are bidding to become the first women to ride the national winner in this. It's 171st running. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has appealed for peace and warned of severe punishment to those disturbing the law and order. Clashes between two groups erupted in Fagwara over the installation of a board and renaming of a chowk. Four persons were injured. Famous Punjabi singer Parmish Verma has been shot at by some miscreants in Mohali. He was rushed to Fortis Hospital soon after the incident took place. The bullet hit Verma's leg, however, he is currently out of danger. The Pakistan High Commission has issued visas to about 2,100 Sikh pilgrims who are visiting the neighbouring country on the occasion of Baisakhi. The pilgrims will visit shrines in Pakistan till April 21st. Days earlier, India and Pakistan agreed to de-escalate tensions over the diplomat's row. A Sikh group has held a protest in the UN against atrocities on minorities and Dalits in India on the birth anniversary of B.R. Ambedkar. Around 25 Sikhs wore black turban as India's permanent representative Sayyid Akbaruddin spoke. Five travel agents have been booked for allegedly selling a woman to a sheikh in Oman. The victim, Baljeet Kaur, was sold as a servant. She returned to India and filed a complaint against the five travel agents. Baljeet was brought back to India as police pressurized the agents. The panel probing sedition cases against SED Amritsar Chief Simranjit Singh Mann and Aam Aadmi Party MLA Sukhpal Singh Khera have been dismissed. The panel has recommended action against erring officials. Cases were registered against the duo during the SED-BJP rule. Local bodies minister Navjot Singh Sidhu has termed the road rage case as a personal fight. Sidhu claimed that he is capable of handling the case alone. The statement came day after Punjab government sought Sidhu's conviction in the case. Congress leader Sajjan Kumar has told the Delhi High Court that there were no allegations against him of instigating a mob against Sikhs after the assassination of then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Thousands of Sikhs were killed in riots following the killing of Gandhi in October 1984. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has announced 20 crore rupees for the upcoming Khulgarh Memorial, which is to be named after Guru Ravidas. He also announced a degree college in Jalandhar to be named after B.R. Ambedkar. A panel probing incidents of sacrilege is set to complete the inquiry and finalize its report by May end. The commission visited several villages where such incidents had taken place. Retired Justice Ranjit Singh interacted with hundreds of people and inquired about the incidents. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Late Sridevi was named the best actress for her role as a vengeful mother in the Hindi film Mom. Her husband and two daughters are overjoyed and said the legacy of the super actor will live on. Sridevi's husband Boni Kapoor and daughter Janvi and Khushi expressed their happiness in a joint statement. We are overjoyed to know that the jury has conferred the Best Actor award to Sridevi for her performance in Mom. It's a very special moment for all of us. She was always a perfectionist and showed in all the 300 plus films she did. She was not just a super actor, but a super wife and a super mother. It's time to celebrate her life and her achievements. She's not with us today, but her legacy will always live on. We thank the Government of India, the Honorable Jury members for this honor. We also take this opportunity to thank all our friends, her fans, who have been sending us congratulatory messages, the statement read. Sridevi died in February in a Dubai hotel, leaving the film industry, her family and legions of fans in a state of shock. Filmmaker Shekhar Kapoor, jury chairperson for the 65th National Film Awards, told the media that his Mr. India actress, Sridevi, wasn't chosen for the honour because of his relationship with her, but due to her contribution to Mom. Entrepreneur Suzanne Khan, former wife of actor Hrithik Roshan, launched a new range of her store collection in collaboration with Minjal J. Her brother Zayed and his wife Malaika, parents Sanjay Khan and Zareen Khan also walked in to support Suzanne on the occasion. Hrithik Roshan walked in later in blue jeans, t-shirt and a cap. Well, the couple, post their divorce, haven't turned into foes, rather seems to enjoy each other's company and support them in their endeavours. Meanwhile, Suzanne and Gauri are passionate about interior designs and home decor, which has also become their professional interest. The two ladies had started a collaborative venture, the Charcoal Factory, but the collaboration didn't really work well, and there was also news of a tiff between the two over the venture. During the launch, she also spoke about her competition with Gauri Khan, who is into similar profession. She said,
I think Gauri is my very, very good friend. There's no competition between us, so we always work together and all of that. So there's no, I think it's lovely that we all are doing so well, and I'm proud that we all are together. And I think in a film world and in the world of design, you need to be together to grow and work in, you know, like in collaborations and in associations. And those are the things that work in a nice way.